When I started web design, I went from beginner to nearly doubling my salary in just 1 year. Not because I was the fastest learner, but because I figured out a way to make learning web design easy. So in this video, I'm gonna give you the 5 biggest uncommon lessons that I learned in those early years. That way you can shortcut the trial and error and take your path to becoming a pro web designer off of hard mode. Are you ready? Let's go. When most people go to learn something new, they think, oh, I know, I'm gonna get a course or maybe watch a YouTube video. But that's not the best way to learn. Let me explain by giving you an example. For a season, my wife and I got really into watching a popular baking show. Inspired by the show, I decided that I knew enough about baking to make my own sourdough bread, but the results weren't quite what I had seen on Netflix. And why is that? Because watching someone else bake doesn't make you a baker. And it's the same with web design. Tutorials can show you what to do, but until you build something for yourself, by yourself, the skills never stick. That's why the first uncommon lesson is you have to learn by doing, not by watching. So your first assignment, over and above everything else, is to get out there and actually build something. And it doesn't matter what it is, right? It could be a friend site. It could be a personal project, maybe a made up business that you got from ChatGPT. Just make sure that you're actively working on a project as you're actively educating yourself. The only pitfall with learning by building is that the second you start, it can be overwhelming because there's just so much to learn. But not all web design skills are created equal. Some skills are foundational, meaning that they show up in every single project that you ever touch. Others, like animation or SEO, even frameworks, even some hardcore development, are important, but they're still situational. And if you dive too fast into those situational skills, you're gonna start to get overwhelmed. That's why so many web designers feel stuck. So if you wanna grow fast as a web designer, you've gotta know the next uncommon lesson and focus on what really matters. Let the situational skills develop over time as you need them on real world projects. But let the majority of your time be on those foundational skills. But out of everything in web design, what should you master first and what can you put on the back burner? Think about what you see on almost any site. Every site has typography, and typically, there's a lot of typography. In fact, text can take up to 80% of a web page. Every site has color. Even minimal sites will have a splash of color. Every site has layout, or the way elements on a page are structured to guide the user's eye. But here's the good news. If you master these basics, you're gonna be about 80% of the way there. So focus on these skills. Practice them. When other things pop up on projects that you're working on, like SEO, sure, spend some time getting familiar with it, but don't get sucked down rabbit holes too far and forget what's really important. By the way, I've got a few videos where I dive even deeper into each of the foundational skills. I'll leave links in the description for you to check them out. Now that you know which skills to focus on, the next challenge is where you practice them. And here's where a lot of beginners get tripped up. They bounce from one tool to the next over and over again. And it might feel like you're moving forward, but really you're just starting from zero all over again every time you try something out or go with a different tool. And I unfortunately got sucked into this pitfall and the early days. I would just pick random WordPress themes based on how they looked or maybe what my client had asked for. But then when I would get everything set up, I'd pop open WordPress and would instantly feel like I just landed in a different world. Eventually, I realized that instead of jumping from one tool to the next, I needed to learn the next uncommon lesson. And that is you need to pick what's called a tech stack. Your tech stack is a list of all the tools that you use to get the job done. For instance, you might use Figma to create vectors, maybe Photoshop to adjust images, and then maybe Framer to build your website. You just want to be careful not to overcomplicate your tech stack, especially in the early days. At the foundation, all you really need is a tool that works with photos for things like compression or maybe image adjustments, a tool that works with vectors for things like logos or icons, and a tool to actually build the website. And there are all sorts of tools out there for each of these jobs, ranging from pretty hard to fairly easy. But there's actually a tool that works with both photos and vectors called Kittle. It's simple and powerful and saves you a ton of time so you can focus on what actually matters building great sites. Plus, it has a really cool feature called Flows that lets you test out different variations of the same idea. This is gonna save you from having to tinker until you finally get something that looks the way you want it. Pair that with Show It for the site itself, and you've got a streamlined stack that will take a huge chunk out of your learning curve. Oh, and if you use Kittle with my link, you get a 25% discount as a new user. The link will be in the description. But here's the plot twist. Even if you nail everything that I just shared, there's one missing piece that will either accelerate your growth by months or trap you in the same place for a long time. And that missing piece is the next uncommon lesson, and it's called a feedback loop. A feedback loop in web design looks like this. You make the website, then you ask for feedback, then you make revisions based on that feedback, and then the loop starts all over again. But without this middle step, you're not really practicing. You're just repeating your mistakes over and over without realizing it. But be careful, because not all feedback is created equal. You don't want people who are just gonna tell you, oh, that looks nice, good job, without really any kind of experience in web design or a willingness to be critical if you really need it. You want people who are also trying to grow as web designers that are willing to give specific feedback when you ask for it. So where do you find this community? Here's what I've learned. It's not about finding the biggest, most popular group. It's about finding meaningful connections. You want a community where you can actually get to know people and they can get to know you. And you want folks who are actively discussing things, right? They're not just ghosting people who ask questions or ask for feedback. You can even look for communities that are based around a specific tool or a specific area. So, you know, like one for Show It designers, Framer developers, or maybe even a broader category of freelance web designers. I run the Show It designer community with thousands of designers. And what makes it work isn't the size. It's that we're all solving similar problems and genuinely want to help each other grow. Okay, you've learned by building real projects by yourself. You focused on the skills that actually mattered. You picked a tech stack and you developed a feedback loop. Congratulations, you're about 90% ahead of most beginners. But there's one final ingredient that transforms everything that you've just learned from knowledge into real expertise. Most designers want everything to feel perfect before they show their work or actually try to get clients. But perfection is just procrastination in disguise. The longer you hide behind practice projects or a little more education, the longer it takes to build the confidence and experience that only come from real deadlines and real people. So the final uncommon learning is this: you've got to get clients as soon as possible. The very first website that I built wasn't for myself, it was for a client. And I was upfront about where I was in my web design journey, but they were willing to give me a shot. You'll learn more from one real client project than you would 10 polished practice projects. That's the difference between staying a student forever and actually becoming a pro. Now, I know that getting clients might feel tough, even for web designers who have been at it for a while, but I've got a method that is guaranteed to open up some doors for you, even if you're just getting started. In fact, it's the exact same method I used to land my first client without any experience. So check out this video where I go deep into that framework so you can start actually building client sites today. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and subscribe if you haven't already. And don't forget, if you don't quit, you win.